Fast Forward Medical Innovation helps biomedical researchers accelerate innovation from idea to impact through commercialization education, business development support, funding, and mentorship expertise. This video focuses on important considerations for digital health technology development. So, you have an idea that could impact patient care using a digital platform. Your first instinct might be to get started with the technical development process. This is important, but the initial focus should be on the non-technical aspects that are going to influence your success, like customer discovery, intellectual property, regulatory considerations, and identifying your paying customer. To illustrate this, we can follow this roadmap. Create a development blueprint, prototype ideas, develop an intellectual property protection strategy, understand how regulatory bodies will impact your development plan, and build the MVP, or minimum viable product. Let's begin by building a development blueprint. Start by validating the unmet need. Your idea was likely inspired from a problem that you experienced, and it's important to clearly define what that problem is, what's causing it, and what happens if it's not resolved. The next step is to assess the competitive landscape to understand the current and future standards of care. Who has tried to solve this problem before, and what can be learned from that experience, success, or failure? Through this market assessment, you can start to develop customer profiles or key groups that might be influenced by your identified problem and benefit from your solution. They might be clinicians, patients, hospital administration, insurance providers, etc. What frustrates, motivates, or incentivizes them about the current state? Also, consider who will be the paying customer for your digital health technology. Your target customer is likely providers, hospital administration, an insurance provider, or industry partner. In addition, you need to identify who is going to partner with you to offer this technology and at what stage they will get involved. These are not always the same, but will help you define your exit strategy. It's always helpful to look at trends for similar technologies. And when thinking about your paying customer, consider why they will pay. Traditional reimbursement strategies rarely apply for digital health technologies, but margin mitigation or the potential for your customer to save time or costs with an upfront investment in your product may be the best strategy. Can you demonstrate how your product will solve a bottleneck, improve access to care, or make a diagnosis earlier so that downstream care is less costly? Develop a value proposition or a statement about how your solution might impact that particular customer in a beneficial way. Test the hypothesis that your solution is something that they want or even need by asking. Try to get to the root of the problem, identify that it is a problem, and validate that your solution would be useful. Do this by asking open-ended questions while trying not to sell your idea. This process is called customer discovery. Keep clinical utility in mind. Throughout your customer discovery, you will learn if the problem that you identified really necessitates a digital solution. And if it does, what form might it take? A web application? An app? Does it need to integrate with the EHR? Who needs to access it? What types of information do users need access to? And who do they need to communicate with? Who will pay for it? Overall, this development blueprint is crucial to ensure there's a good fit in the marketplace and your idea will actually solve the key issues that you've identified before you begin writing code or developing a user interface. Don't make the mistake of focusing on what the solution looks like before confirming that it will add value to your customer. Let's assume you've validated the need for your idea. You are now ready for wireframing and concept development. This is the process of prototyping what the screens and the workflow might look like in the final product. At this stage, changing your mind, trying different approaches, and getting feedback from potential users is relatively inexpensive and very fast to do. Dedicate significant time to this process to ensure that your idea is as close to a highly optimized solution as possible before moving on to technical development, which is when things get expensive and time-consuming. The next step in the development roadmap is to consider the potential intellectual property, or IP, and how that might be developed along the way. The proper IP strategy in software depends on the ultimate value you derive from it and may include more than one form of protection. the most recognizable form of IP is patents. For software solutions, patents are sometimes used for protection of methodologies or algorithms. Patents become public knowledge, and defending your patent would require you to be able to prove that someone is doing what you have a patent right to do. That is tricky because software moves very fast, and the patent process, by its nature, is very slow. Another option is copyright, which is your expression of that software in the form of the code that is written. Copyrights are automatic upon writing and provide absolute protection on that code, much like someone has protection on a book or a piece of artwork. However, copyrights are a relatively weak form of protection because the code isn't what the customer is interacting with directly, unlike reading a published novel. The third protection option is open source, which means allowing anyone access to the code and to manipulate and adjust it for their needs. This is a viable option for IP protection because open source code attributes back to the original developers. Most open source licenses will require a new user to declare where the source code came from and who developed it. If the highest value for you is to be known as the originating source or the thought leader in your field, this is a viable and appropriate option. Finally, a trade secret strategy is common in software and does not publicly disclose how the idea is produced. The protection lasts as long as the secret is kept. For example, what is the secret formula of Coca-Cola? Consider the trade secret route if your technology is probably going to grow and change over time. If you are at an academic institution, contact your technology transfer office to discuss the most appropriate IP strategy for your digital health technology. The third step in the roadmap is to look at how regulatory considerations from the FDA and HIPAA will impact your development plan. First, you need to determine if the FDA will have purview over your digital health technology. The FDA regulates medical technologies that have the potential to impact patient diagnosis or treatment. For a general guideline, you can follow this series of questions. Make sure to seek guidance from a regulatory professional to confirm your plan. Does your digital solution diagnose or provide clinician decision support? If your technology treats, diagnoses, or provides decision support, the FDA may retain the right to regulate your technology. If your technology most likely requires FDA regulation, how is it regulated? Is your digital solution within a medical device? Does it drive hardware that accomplishes the intended purpose? For example, software driving an IV infusion pump on its own does not have any effect unless it is coupled with an IV pump. If the answer is yes, the software will likely be regulated as part of the hardware device. Alternatively, is the software itself classified as a medical device? For example, a mobile app that can take a picture of a mole and make a diagnosis or recommendation would be classified as a medical device. If your digital health technology is regulated by the FDA as a medical device, the regulatory pathway will be decided by the intended use and indications for use of the technology. The amount of FDA regulatory oversight will escalate as the risk to the patient increases. The FDA has released several guidance documents to help you understand and identify exactly where you fall within the spectrum of regulation. With proper guidance, it's a good idea to have a pre-submission meeting with the FDA to help guide your regulatory decision process. Second, consider HIPAA, which includes standard processes for electronic healthcare transactions. For early stage software development, this means implementing security and privacy to protect patient health information. These guidelines will ensure information is only shared with those that should have access to it and denies access to those who shouldn't. Do you have the appropriate technical controls on the application to ensure that it can't be intercepted? The next section of the roadmap is the MVP, or minimum viable product. The MVP is the minimum set of features and functions that your product needs to be testable in your local environment. Think must-have versus nice-to-have. An MVP contains the essentials to test your digital health technology, but the final product could include the bells and whistles. For example, an MVP could be a standalone app that performs essential functions outside of the EHR, but may require direct input from clinicians or patients. Because integrating with the EHR is complex, technically difficult, and expensive, it may not be considered essential in the MVP. The app will function within your environment, allowing you to test it earlier without the added development costs of being a fully EHR integrated app. Now that you have your MVP built, use this to conduct further customer discovery and ultimately launch your idea. With a proper development blueprint and assessment of regulatory and market risks, your digital health technology has the potential to make a huge difference in the precision and speed of patient care. For more information, check out Fast Forward Medical Innovation online.